And in the next example, I'm going to do something really forbidden. Oh, spooky boy. Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video on my bachelor's paper. And it's going to be a little quickie today because we are just going to talk about sub-algebraic structures. Sub-magmas at that. At first, I want you guys to remember what a magma actually is. Well, we have a non-empty set M, for example, together with a binary operation. It's going to form a pair. And we are going to call this pair right here exactly a magma, if and only if, so this thing right here is a magma, if and only if, for all elements x, y, out of this M, we have that x in composition with y is once again element of M. That's what you call closure under this operation. Watch my previous video on this topic. And now I want you guys to consider a non-empty subset. This is just for convention purposes, because group theorists and all those crazy people say, we don't want those sets to be empty. Yeah, I'm going to do something forbidden in the end, so watch till the end. Okay, let's consider a non-empty subset as, for example, of M. Remember what subset means? Subset only means that all the elements here in S are indeed contained in M. And it can also possibly be the whole set M right here. But it's a subset. We don't know anything about that. Never mind. And also, I want you guys to consider this S as a pair with the operation of the mother magma. So let's consider S and circle once again. And we call this thing right here a submagma, this pair, if, well, S is closed under the operation of its mother magma right here. So that means, for all x and y, element of S, we have that x in composition with y is once again element of S. That's all it really is. And once this holds, we can also denote the submagma or subgroup or subsemigroup, never mind, as just S being less or equal, you could say, than M. This is not the subset symbol, it's the less or equal symbol. Just for convention purposes. Okay, and now I would like to give you two little examples of submagmas, where at first I want you guys to consider the fact that every set is a subset of itself. It does make sense. So let's consider M being a subset of M. Well, M is indeed a subset of M because all the elements in M are contained in M. Yeah, right, cool. First condition of a submagma fulfilled. And also we want this mother set M right here, together with a binary operation circle, to be a magma. So we want to have M and the circle to be a magma. Well, meaning this pair right here is closed under the operation. Definition of a magma. Now we want to take this subset of M, together with the operation of its mother magma, circ. Now we want to consider this right here, you could say, M and circle. And we want to show that this thing right here is indeed closed under the operation of its mother set. But yeah, it is because, well, we know that this right here is already a magma, so this also forms a magma. Meaning every magma is a submagma of itself. Really quite cool. Meaning we can also denote it as M being less or equal to M. And in the next example, I'm going to do something really forbidden. Oh, spooky boy. So this next one is really quite spooky. I should have done this as my Halloween special because all the group theorists and semi-group theorists are now going to run away because I'm going to say that the empty set is indeed a submagma of every magma. M with a little circle, binary operation. I have just, broken the rules of semi-group theory. I'm terribly sorry. Oh, I hit my microphone. Okay, so at first we have to make sure that the empty set is indeed the subset of every set. So this is what we have to confirm at first. Don't forget what it means. For something to be a subset of some arbitrary set, well, it just means that all the elements of the empty set are indeed contained in our mother set, M. But you see, in the empty set, there are no elements that could be contained in here. Meaning also that all the elements of the empty set, there are no, are indeed contained in the mother set. So yeah, the empty set is indeed a subset of every set. Try it out for yourself. It's really quite an easy argumentation. Now all that we have to show, since this right here holds, we have to show that this empty set and the operation of its mother set M form a magma. Meaning that's equivalent to saying that for all x and y element of the empty set, we have that, well, x in composition with y is once again element of the empty set. And here comes a little proof by contradiction, you could say. Well, why not suppose the opposite? Assume that there is some x and y element of the empty set such that x in composition with y is once again element of the empty set. We are going to suppose this. But you see, there are no elements of the empty set which could fulfill this right here, this condition. So you see the empty set is empty, meaning there are no elements in it. So that also means that exactly there are no elements that could, in composition, be element of the empty set once again. Meaning, on the other hand, we have just shown this vacuously, that for all x and y, we also have that they in composition are once again element of the empty set. Just play it through. It's really quite easy to understand, it's not hard. And then we are done. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video. I'm sorry for breaking the rules of group theory right here, but that's quite a nice example. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe and recommend the channel if you like. If you want to support the channel a bit more, take a look into the description. There's a link to my Patreon, to my Teespring account, or just watch my videos. This already helps a lot. And up until the next video, have a flammy boy day. See ya.
Jetzt filme ich ihn, wie er sich seinen Lümmel ableckt. Na toll.